All right, game two between Big Beast and Tidiest Chunk, aka Hidden Squid, is going to be on Winter's Get. So it is a Protoss Big Beast in the bottom right versus our Terran player Tidiest Chunk up in the top left. Yeah, so game one, arguably a reasonably one-sided affair. Oh no, what am I doing? I'm trying to set the scores. There we go. Best of three, 1-0. When it came to the fights, but actually, to be fair, both players had in fact done a reasonable job of macroing in terms of they had both expanded, they had both built plenty of production facilities. So our, you know, Protoss player did have several gateways, did have a robo, did have a starport, those types of things, a stargate, sorry. And our Terran player similarly did have a factory, did have several barracks so they could pump out those units quickly enough. Both players had fairly unusual compositions though, and both opened with these just really bizarre kind of multi, you know, three pylons. At this time, like, no, you just don't need it. If you don't need it, don't build it, you know. There isn't any advantage to building that. Your money would have been better spent teching up more quickly, you know. You could have, if you didn't have these two pylons, you would have had a much faster cybernetics core, or you would have had a much faster expand, etc. And similarly on the other side of the map, like all of these supply depots, you know, I'd much rather see an expand, or I'd much rather see a factory, a quicker factory, or, you know, three more barracks. Anything like that is going to be better than massively oversupplying. Now, with that said, Big Beast is fast approaching that supply. As a kind of general tip for playing StarCraft, if you can get into the habit of just while you're playing, just glancing up in the top right corner of your screen, you know, every, you want to enjoy the game, it doesn't want to be a job, but at the same time, just glancing up into that top right corner, and what you're checking is your supply. Are you going to be supply blocked anytime soon? Because if you are, you want to start building the pylons before you're supply blocked, because they take time. And the other thing you're looking for is, you're just looking at your money, basically. Have you got a lot of unspent resources? Because if you have, the thing to do is to build more buildings so that you can build faster. I think these units might be trapped. I'm not sure they can get out of there. It's hard to tell. Maybe that guy can't just fit on the edge. You can, of course, lift Terran buildings off, so now they can escape. Yeah, turns out they were trapped. If you land this again, you don't have to fly it away. You can land again and just set the rally point on this side. By default, units always come out below a building as you look at it on screen. So a unit from here will come out underneath a unit from your, if it isn't rallied anywhere, a unit from your command center will come out underneath. But as soon as you've set a rally point, they'll come out on the side in the direction of the rally point. So so you didn't actually have to lift the building up and keep it lifted. You could have re-landed it and just set a rally point to fix that. So plus one attack is coming out from the Terran, and if you're going sort of marine heavy composition, plus one attack is a very worthwhile upgrade indeed. But combat shield is just so important for your marines. Amy W, that is Yuki, who is gonna help me out with some of the casting, because you know, once we get up and running, once the replays start coming in thick and fast, I'm not going to be able to cast anything like all the games. So I'll send him a reply in a little bit. Anywho, this composition doesn't look dissimilar to last time. We've got a couple of Void Rays in the mix. And honestly, there's nothing wrong with building Void Rays, nothing wrong with that at all. But, you know, they're better probably used as a harassing unit or as a kind of absolutely max out on them unit. Having them in combination with an army can be useful, sort of depends on the type of composition you're going for. So if you've got a Terran with siege tanks, it can be handy to have a couple of void rays, because with that prismatic alignment, they will focus on siege tanks very quickly. And of course, they're air units, and siege tanks can't shoot air. Look at what is happening here. This light is disgusting. Alrighty. So not a great deal happening at present. Both players just focusing on building their stuff up. So workers-wise, Thaddeus Chunk has kind of stopped building workers far too soon, really. As a general rule, don't stop building workers until it's tricky because when you're new to the game, you can't really macro well enough to spend the money quickly enough. So, you probably don't need even three fully saturated bases. You'd probably be all right with two at any given time. But certainly 56 workers or so, I would suggest, is sensible. Personally, if I'm playing Protoss, I tend to go up to sort of 75, 80 workers, somewhere in that sort of region. If I'm playing Terran, something similar. If I'm playing Zerg, I'll sometimes go a little bit higher, up to the sort of 85 workers or thereabouts. So yeah, don't be shy, but at the same time, definitely don't sort of stop at like below 30, because you will run out of money. It's as simple as that. Once you do have your worker count at like sort of 70 or something like that, then you can really ramp up your production. If you're a Terran with 80 workers on the map, like you can be cranking Marines out of 12 barracks. And Marines are quick to build. That's a lot of firepower that you can output very, very quickly. And you can trade those out because they don't even cost gas. Similarly, as Protoss, you can go up to sort of 20 getaways or something. So that you can produce units at a phenomenal rate. But you do need a lot of income for that. This is going to be a one-sided fight again. Again, the Terran can't actually see the Protoss army, which is making it tricky. The Mama ship is going to tank a lot. It's got an awful lot of health. It's got a lot of shield, so it's taking all the fire. And that fight did look very one-sided, with a lot of the Terran army simply unable to attack. Marauders, Reapers don't shoot up, and if the stuff that's actually on the ground is cloaked, then not much you can do about it. As a top tip, as Terran, you can turn your command center into an orbital command. That has two important bonuses. One is that you can drop mules on mineral patches. Mules mine much quicker than SCVs, so it gives you income a boost. And two, you do have to save up energy for it, but your command center can scan. So, click on your command center, tap C, and click the map, and it will scan an area that will reveal any cloaked units in that area for a certain amount of time. So, if something like a mothership turns up with a cloaked army under it, or indeed Dark Templars or anything like that, you can just drop the scan. So there we have it. That's going to be, well, I was going to say GG, but I don't know that we're going to get a GG. We're just going to get the end of buildings, and it is a fairly robust victory that time for Baked Beans. GG.